Let's consider another example, and that is about parallel plate capacitors. So, in order to increase the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor, it's a good idea to fill the separation between two parallel plates with a dielectric material, because as a response to the electric field developed inside, the dielectric material will develop a polarization, and in turn the potential difference for a given amount of charge will decrease. With that, the capacitance of that capacitor will increase. Once that happens, that's helpful for practical purposes, and that's why it's a good idea to fill the space between two plates with a dielectric material. Let's assume we have a parallel plate capacitor where the region between two plates has been filled with dielectric material. So here is one plate. Here is another plate like this. And in between that, we have a material with epsilon r as the relative permittivity. And the electric field is confined to the space between the planes, and it's not outside. So we will have, with this dielectric filling, the capacitance that is equals total charge on each plate over the potential difference that's developed, and that means this will become epsilon r times the capacitance if there was vacuum in between these two plates. That means we are increasing the capacitance of this parallel plate capacitor by putting a dielectric material in between. Now, if the dielectric material were not linear, if we had a non-linear dielectric material, then what kind of susceptibility did we have, and what kind of situation could we expect? Then, with a dielectric material where the susceptibility is not a scalar and it's in general a tensor, we can write down as a function, as a response of the electric field, the polarization would look something like this. Px is epsilon naught chi electric xx ex plus chi e xy ey plus chi e xz ez. Similarly, py can be written as and Pz can be written as this would be Zx.